He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
In the previous tutorial, we learned about coronaviruses of the past and how our knowledge shifted when the SARS global pandemic happened in 2003. It turns out that the latest novel coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2, which causes the disease called COVID-19, is the third novel coronavirus to cause a large-scale outbreak. So let's first talk about the second novel coronavirus to cause a big outbreak before moving on to COVID. Middle East Respiratory Syndrome Coronavirus, or MERS coronavirus, was first reported in Saudi Arabia in 2012. Like SARS, MERS coronavirus causes a lower respiratory tract infection in humans. But unlike SARS, MERS has a 35% mortality rate. All cases of MERS have been linked to travel or residence in or near the Arabian Peninsula, and most people that caught it developed severe respiratory illness with a fever, cough, and shortness of breath. Since MERS was discovered, over 2,200 lab-confirmed cases have been reported, along with over 800 deaths. In general, there's really no need to worry about getting MERS unless you or someone you know is traveling to or from the Arabian Peninsula anytime soon. But MERS is the second example of an unexpectedly highly pathogenic coronavirus spilling over into the human population. Now let's get back to the third novel coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2. The Coronaviridae Study Group of the International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses has grouped all the highly pathogenic coronaviruses into the beta coronavirus genus, group 2, within the Coronaviridae family. Compared to SARS coronavirus or MERS coronavirus, SARS-CoV-2 appears to be less lethal, meaning it has a lower mortality rate, but it does have higher transmissibility. Like the other viruses in this family, SARS-CoV-2 is an enveloped, positive-sense, single-stranded RNA virus, and its genome shares about 80% sequence identity with SARS-CoV and about 50% with MERS coronavirus. Like the original SARS-CoV, the SARS-CoV-2 genome encodes four structural proteins of importance to build its spherical, spike-covered shape. As we recall, those are spike, envelope, membrane, and nucleocapsid, abbreviated as S, E, M, and N, respectively. The spike protein is what the virus uses to get into a cell by binding to a receptor called angiotensin converting enzyme 2, or ACE2, on the surface of host cells. What's interesting here is that the gene that encodes the spike protein of SARS-CoV-2 is highly variable from the gene that encodes the spike protein of SARS-CoV, sharing less than 75% nucleotide identity. We don't fully know all the ins and outs of this yet, but generally speaking, even tiny differences in the genetic sequences of similar viruses could have significant effects on their function. In this case, it seems that the differences in the spike protein make SARS-CoV-2 able to bind more tightly to the host cell receptor than SARS-CoV is able to. Once SARS-CoV-2 enters the host, meaning when the host breathes in the virus binds to multiple different types of cells in the respiratory tract, just like SARS-CoV, and starts replicating there. Even though both SARS-CoV and SARS-CoV-2 infect the lower respiratory tract, data suggests that SARS-CoV-2 has the ability to efficiently infect the upper respiratory tract as well, which may help the virus spread to other humans more rapidly and effectively. So far, we know that SARS-CoV-2 is similar to SARS-CoV in the structure of its genome, the types of tissues it infects, or its tissue tropism, and the general development of disease, but there are still many questions to be answered. As of the date this tutorial is being published, scientists are investigating why COVID-19 appears to be more transmissible, along with the infinitely complex immune responses to SARS-CoV-2. understanding the ways that the virus activates or hides from different parts of the immune system in different people will be incredibly important in the development of a vaccine and will likely help us understand future viruses even better as well. As researchers race to find the answers, the biggest things we can do are to wear masks in public, stay socially distanced from one another, and keep learning all that we can.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.